person with ID10T who suffers from ID10T errors would steal a smartphone. Now I'm going to show you why. All of the smartphone platforms offer you the ability to set up what is called tracking on the phone. So you don't even need the assistance of the telcos to find your device. You can get apps, some already have it built in, that you can configure it, and if something goes wrong, all you have to do is find a computer with internet and you'll be able to track the location of your device. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to show you how to set it up on two of those platforms. So I'm going to start here with the Android platform. The Avast antivirus has a mobile security app for Android devices. In addition to providing you with security in terms of scanning your apps to ensure that they're not malicious, it has a very cool feature where it will allow you to install a particular application that will track the device for you. But to be on the safe side, again, what it does is disguise that application as a random application on the tablet. So I'm going to go through the process of showing you that right now. So to start, we would go to the Play Store. Go ahead, go through the process and install it. Open up the Avast application. And when it opens up, as you can see, I have a bar beside I can expand to see what is going on. It can give me information about the scans. What I want to do is go into setup right here. And then I am going to go and I'm going to look for advanced. When you look at the menu here, it gives you all sort of information. So if, again, remember I said that Avast has multiple functions. So it will scan, it will tell you what each app does, what they're doing, which apps you have installed, all options. But what I am interested in is this one right here. Now it says I'm in the installation mode and it says advanced installation mode. And I click on that and I click continue. Avast anti-theft is able to run on your phone as normal installation. So this is the process we're going through. So I click continue and application name. What it does is give me the option to give the application a different name. Because if you take up a device and it says anti-theft application, the first thing you're going to do is go to and install it. So I'm just going to give it an innocuous name. So now it is downloading the application. Once that is completed, all I need to do is select install. Now that we're finished installing, we open, right? And it gives me an option here to personalize it. Okay, they want me to change a PIN, 4 to 6 digits, and we're just going to use, and this is just for demonstration purposes. People, do not put in 11111 or 123456. Be a little creative. Use something that will force people to think a little, but something you can remember. I could go ahead now and set up an Avast account, and then I would log in and I'd be able to go directly and track my device over the internet. So I just showed you how to do it on an Android. Now I'm going to show you how to do this, get this done on a BlackBerry. Now BlackBerry is notorious for having these kind of security features. So they actually have something kind of built in. So all I need to do is go into system. Let's see if I can find it. Right, and there I have it. And then I go to BlackBerry ID. I have backup and protect. Very protect. And I'm going to turn this on. So slide across. The one thing you should notice is that in order to use this, your location has to be turned on, so that the GPS will be tracking your location and will know your locations. Now, this setup is actually two parts. So one, I have to do this setup on the phone, and then I go to my laptop and connect to protect.blackberry.com, and then I will continue the setup process from there. All it requires is for you to enable it on your BlackBerry device, and then create your BlackBerry ID, log in with your BlackBerry ID, confirm your email address, and look at that. Now I have all of these options that I can go into. So for example, if I go to view location, it says, and look at this, attempting to locate device. This ought to tell you folks, even if this brilliant criminal decides to take out your SIM card and throw it in a ditch, you will still be able to find your location using GPS and see us right there. Look at that. You can display a message, so you can see to display a customized message to anyone who finds the phone. So if somebody picks up the phone and tries to send a message to pop up and say, okay, this is the phone of so and so. If you have found it, you can contact us at XYZ. You can also play a sound. Remember, this is also very useful because a lot of times your phone might be on silent. It will turn it to loud profile and play the sound so you can try and locate the phone. You can lock it so that they can't access anything within the device, and you can wipe the device, wipe all the information on the device just by logging into your BlackBerry Protect ID. So now we have shown you how to do this for two devices, which is the Android platform and the BlackBerry platform. Now if I had multiple devices, as you can see right here, it would give me an option to select which one I need to go to. So this is actually quite good from BlackBerry. Don't need to worry, and I don't want the Apple fans to feel left out. What will happen is that I don't have enough time to do all phones for this segment. So what I will do is post the video for the Apple on our YouTube channel, so you can check it out at Total Technocrat.